Right, welcome back to the NIA interactive sessions on how to install and develop a site using CMS Made Simple. So last time we installed CMS Made Simple, here it is fully installed. It only took a few minutes to do so. And we have the website up here, and then we also have the administrative area of the website where you can administer, you can customize, you can do all kinds of stuff to your site. So on the site itself, these are all dummy files. These are all placeholders, and they serve as useful models, but obviously this is not the site that you would use yourself, although you could use this theme. But here you can see you have several pages. You have the home page, as you can see, and then we have information about CMS Made Simple. These are good read-throughs here in terms of documentation, but you see we have four main pages: home, how CMS works, default templates, and default extensions. And then under each one of these, we also have some sub pages. So we click on any one of the pages, it even shows you how to use a different theme. And you can see here now the menu drops over to the side. And you can see all of this. There's a lot of pages that come installed with it, and we're going to figure out how to customize those. So we go back to the admin area, and there really are a couple of main sections here in the admin that you need to be concerned about. The first one is content, and this is where our content itself is. So if we click on content, inside of content we have three options here: content manager, file manager, and news. The content manager is where all your pages are. So content manager are your pages. So when you have pages that show up here, those pages are basically inside of content manager, and you can see here they match exactly in terms of order and in terms of content. You have all the information here. So this is the home page, and then if you want to edit the page, and then you see the additional pages, and then you click the little blue button, you get the sub pages inside of here, and you can do any editing here. And then you click on home, and you can do any editing inside of any one of the pages. And inside any one of the pages, you have a real good WYSIWYG editor up here, standard WYSIWYG Tiny MCE editor, which works very similarly to Microsoft Word. So if you or any of your clients are using Microsoft Word, they can figure out how to do this. You can select on something, click on bold, however you want to do. And then there's all kinds of other options here, which we'll go into greater detail, but navigation, which will let you put this page under another page. You can include specific metadata, and then you can change the template or the theme, change the page name, and change permissions and all that. So that is the content manager. The other areas inside of content is the file manager, and this is where you keep all of your files. So these are where your images are. Here are the different themes, and you can upload files into the themes. Right now we have images here, and we can upload some other images inside of here. You just choose your file and you can upload it here. And then news is a basic blog. So out of the box, CMS Made Simple comes ready to blog. You have this blog here, you add an article, and then you can select a category, and then you can select, you can insert both a summary and a main content area, and the two do not have to be identical. Obviously the summary can be a short version of the content, but it doesn't have to be that way. You can set the post dates, you can set it to publish in the future, or you can set it to publish in the past if I want to push it back a day, and submit. And then as you'll see when you come here, the next article automatically shows up here. So that's the news area and the content. The other important area is the layout. So if we go back here to the dashboard, the layout has a design manager, and this is where you set up your themes and your templates. So the layouts have two really important parts to it. One is the design, and the design is what most of us will call the theme or the look and feel of the site, and that would be an overall theme. So here are the themes that come installed, include Simplex and and Clean Blue. Those are two that we've seen out there. And then, so this is basically a placeholder or some a container for the templates and style sheets. So then once you set up a design and there's really nothing in the design, you just create it and it's just really blank other than the name, then you can put inside the design several templates. So you can have a home page that's this particular way, and then you can have an internal page that looks a little bit different, or you can have a news page that looks different than the home page. So you could then put inside of a theme, you could put multiple templates in there, and that really separates the idea of theme versus templates as well. And then you can keep the style sheets where they are in your template, which usually come in a CSS folder or directory, or you can install the style sheets in here, either replace them or you can use them as additional, the ones that you want to customize in here. So the design manager then holds your designs, and then inside of your design you have templates and even style sheets. Here you also have in the back end you have the user management, and that lets you add users to your back end. You can also add groups. It comes out of the box with admin, editor, and designer, but you can have whatever groups you want. And then you can set permission for each one of the back end groups. So some of them can add templates, like a designer, but an editor wouldn't add the templates. The editor would just manage the content and do some other things, like maybe add news to the news stories. Extensions lets you administer or figure out what the extensions you have installed on the site, and then it lets you manage some of them. So here you can customize or configure some of the existing extensions that you have. In the site admin, there's all kinds of settings that you have here for the site as a whole, sometimes even for some of the individual modules or extensions or plugins, but really you have these settings for the content manager in general, the design manager, just an overall website management here. And you should really take a look at each one of these in turn. And an important one here is the module manager. So this is where you can either upload your modules or your extensions, or you can just install them right from inside of here. So instead of, you can upload them by clicking on import, or you can just go to available modules and you can see a list of all the modules or extensions that are available here in CMS Made Simple. And then you click on download install and automatically installs in your system, and we'll be looking at which ones we're installing here next. So this is a quick look at the back end, a quick look at the admin area of CMS Made Simple. Next we'll go into installing a theme and some templates into our new website.